Hello students, so in the previous video we had discussed about the introduction of dipole, what is electric dipole, what is dipole moment, what is the direction of dipole moment, etc. etc. Fine, in today's lecture we'll be discussing about how to calculate electric field because of dipole along the axis and along the equator. Okay, see, electric field because of dipole along its axis, right? Axis is also known as end on position. End on position. You have been told to calculate electric field along the axis of the dipole or end on position. See, suppose this is your axis. I am placing a dipole over here this way. Dipole means minus q plus q, and let the finite distance be 2a. Let this is the center of the dipole, so this will be a, this will also be a, and this is the direction of dipole moment. Okay, dipole moment is a vector quantity which is directed from negative to positive. Fine, so see, the dipole is placed over here and we have been told to calculate electric field along the axis of the dipole. Along the axis of the dipole means somewhere here. Okay, so let us calculate electric field at this point. Let us say this point is P and this is, say, at a distance z from the origin, from the axis. Clear? So this is your dipole. This is the axis of the dipole, this is the equator. Clear? We have been told to calculate, or we want to calculate electric field at a point P, which is at a distance Z. Okay, so this is A, this is Z, so this will be Z minus A. Clear? This distance is Z, this is A, so this will be Z minus A. Got it, students? And this distance will be, this is A, this is Z, this is Z, this is A. So this will be Z plus A. Clear? Okay. This distance is Z. This is A. So this will be Z minus A and this will be Z plus A. Now for a positive charge, electric field at a point P will be away. And for a negative charge, electric field will be towards itself. Clear? For a positive charge, electric field will be away from the point, and for a negative charge, it will be towards. But since positive charge is nearer to the point, right, it is at a distance of Z minus A, and negative charge is at a distance of Z plus A. Clear? So magnitude wise, this electric field due to positive charge will be more in magnitude. So net electric field will be this way. Okay, students, got it? Electric field, because of this positive charge will be away, because of negative charge will be towards itself, but since positive charge is at a greater, positive charge is at a less distance, so net electric field will be in this direction. Clear? So yes, this net electric field and the dipole moment, this vector and net electric field, both are in same direction, so the angle between them is zero. This can be asked as MCQ. That what is the angle between net electric field and dipole moment for a dipole lying along the axis. So for a dipole lying along the axis, the angle between net electric field and dipole moment is 0 degree. Fine. So now let us calculate the electric field at point P. So it is due to positive charge and due to negative charge. Okay, so for a point charge, electric field is KQ by R square. So this will be KQ by Z minus A the whole square. Clear? Minus KQ by Z plus A the whole square, because electric field are in opposite direction. And P caret. This is a unit vector. It is to represent the direction of net electric field. It is to represent the direction of net electric field. Since both are in same direction. Clear? Okay. So now this will be KQ is taken common. 1 by Z minus A the whole square, z plus a the whole square into p caret. So this is kq. Let us take LCM, z plus a the whole square minus z minus a the whole square. So middle term will be added up. So it will be 4za upon z square minus a square the whole square p caret. This is your electric field, students. Yeah, z plus a the whole square will go over here. Z minus a the whole square will come over here. Then a plus b the whole square, a square plus 2ab plus b square. Clear? So on expanding, middle term will be added up. So it will be 2ab plus 2ab. That is 4ab. So it is 4z upon this. Now, see students, this 4 can be written as 2 into 2. That means I can rewrite this as 2kz q into 2a upon z square minus a square the whole square p caret. Right? I have just splitted this 4 as 2 into 2. Okay, now what is q into 2a? Q into 2a is p. We had seen this in the previous video. It is dipole moment. So finally, electric field will be 2kpz upon z square minus a square the whole square into p caret. So this is the electric field because of dipole along the axis. Clear? Now, what if the dipole is short dipole? Or in the question, if it has been told that consider the dipole as short dipole, or consider the point at a very far away distance. That means suppose point P, if it is over here, so then Z is quite greater than A. You are getting the point. Suppose I want to calculate electric field at this point. This point is at larger distance. That means if Z is greater than A, right? If Z is greater than A, either they will give this condition or they will mention that the dipole is short dipole, or they will also they can also give us the point is very far. In such cases, we'll take this condition Z greater than A. Otherwise, the formula is derived. This is the formula to calculate electric field because of dipole. 2kpz upon z square minus a square the whole square p caret. This is for dipole along the axis. Now, if z is greater than a, so then a can be neglected. So electric field will be 2kpz. And yes, of course, neglecting the term is possible only with addition and subtraction, not with multiplication or division. So we cannot neglect z from the numerator. If it is a was present here, we cannot neglect a. Z square the whole square, so z raised to 4, a is neglected. Got it, students? So finally, this is 2kp by z cube. This is the electric field because of dipole at far away distance. So at far away distance, electric field because of dipole is inversely proportional to cube of the distance and not as square of the distance. Okay, students, so this can be also asked as MCQ, that at large distance or due to short dipole, electric field varies with distance s, then we'll write it as 1 by r cube and not as 1 by r square. Got it, students? Now we will calculate electric field because of dipole but along the equator. Got it? We will calculate the electric field because of dipole along the equator. Electric field due to dipole along the equator. Equator is also known as broadside position. Broadside. So if you have been told to calculate the electric field along the broadside, that means you will calculate the electric field along the equator. Okay. So now this is electric dipole. Dipole means a system of equal and opposite charges separated by some finite distance. Let this be A, this be A. So the total is 2A. So this is an electric dipole which is lying along Z axis. Now we want to calculate the electric field at a distance Y. but along the equator at a point P. Clear? This is your dipole, and we have been told to calculate the electric field along the equator. Equator means 90 degree to the dipole. Fine. So dipole moment was from negative to positive. So this is the direction of dipole moment. Clear? Once again, a dipole is placed over here. The separation between two charges is 2A. Dipole moment is directed from negative to positive, and we have been calculating electric field at a point P, which is at a distance y from the center of the dipole lying along the equator. Clear? Okay, so now for a positive charge, electric field will be away from the point. So electric field will be this way. This is the electric field due to plus Q charge. Similarly, electric field at point P because of minus charge will be in this direction, because for a negative charge electric field will be towards itself, and for positive charge electric field will be away from it. Okay, now this is electric field due to minus charge. Okay, this is y, this is a, so this will be your hypotenuse, which is y square plus a square, root of y square plus a square. Okay, let us say this angle is theta. If this is theta, this will be also theta, corresponding angle. Clear? Similarly, this will be theta. So now electric field will have its components. That means electric field due to positive charges in this direction. This is theta. So this will be E cos theta. This will be E sin theta. Clear? Similarly, this is electric field of negative charge. This is theta. So this will be cos theta, this will be sin theta. See, sin theta components are opposite to each other, and they are having the same magnitude because the distance is same, root of y square plus a square, root of y square plus a square. So sin component will cancel each other. Clear? So net electric field will be in downward direction, and dipole moment is in upward direction. So the angle between net electric field and dipole moment for a dipole lying along the equator is 180 degree. This can be asked as MCQ. Clear? For a dipole, for a point lying along the axis, the angle between net electric field and dipole moment was 0 degree, but along the equator the angle between net electric field and dipole moment is 180 degree. Clear? Okay, fine. So now net electric field will be electric field due to plus charge, its cos component, electric field due to minus charge, cos component, and minus p caret is a unit vector which is to represent the direction of net electric field. Since both are in opposite direction, I am placing a negative sign. Clear? You can also understand this as net electric field is in negative y direction, so I am placing a negative sign. Clear? Okay, so this will be equals to E plus plus E minus cos theta. I'll place a negative sign over here, P caret. Done? Clear? This is a point charge, and for a point charge electric field is KQ by R square. So this is equals to KQ by R square. This is equals to R. So R square means Y square plus A square plus KQ by y square plus a square. Clear? Electric field due to positive charge, since it is a point charge, so for a point charge electric field will be kq by r square. So r square will be y square plus a square into cos theta. So in this triangle, what is cos theta? Cos theta means adjacent by hypotenuse. So cos theta can be written as a upon y square plus a square raised to 1 by 2 p caret. Clear? Okay. So this will be equals to minus of 2kq upon y square plus a square. This will be the LCM. So y square plus a square raised to 1, and y square plus a square raised to 1 by 2. So it will be 3 by 2 a p caret. Got it? This is y square plus a square to the power 1. Y square plus a square raised to 1 half. So when base are same, power will be added up, so it will be 1 plus 1 by 2, so that is 3 by 2. Now what is Q into 2A? It is P. Q into 2A is P. So net electric field along the equator will be minus kp upon y square plus a square raised to 3 by 2 p caret. This is your net electric field. Clear? Okay. Fine. Now, what if y is greater than a? That means the point where we want to calculate the electric field, if it is quite greater than a, then we can neglect a. So net electric field will be equals to minus kp upon y is quite greater than a, so a can be neglected, so it will be y square raised to 3 by 2, so that is y cube p caret. Clear? So this is the electric field because of dipole along the equator, right? But this formula is to be used only when you are being told that the point is quite far or the dipole is short dipole. Clear? Otherwise, this is the correct formula, minus kp by y square plus a square raised to 3 by 2 p caret. So in both the cases, whether the point is lying along the axis or whether the point is lying along the equator, at far away distance, electric field will change as 1 by r cube for a dipole and not as 1 by r square. This is to be remembered. This is an important point and can be asked as MCQ. That electric field will change as 1 by r cube and not as 1 by r square for a dipole, but when a point is lying very far. Clear? Okay, now we'll solve few questions based on electric dipole. Question 1. Suppose two dipoles are aligned this way, let the angle be 60 degree. You have to find the net dipole moment. Find the magnitude of net dipole moment. Come on. Magnitude of net dipole moment. See, these are two dipoles. One will consider this as minus q plus q, minus q plus q. Here we are having a charge of minus 2q. So one minus q will be making a dipole with plus q over here, and another minus q will be making a dipole with this charge q. So basically we are having two dipoles, minus q plus q, minus q plus q, and these two dipoles are at an angle of 60 degree. Okay, so the dipole moment will be this way, the dipole moment will be this way, and we have been told to calculate the net dipole moment. So by the law of vector addition, if this is your vector 1, this is your another vector, and the angle between them is 60 degree. So net dipole moment will be calculated as, we'll calculate this with the formula a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. Clear? So this will be a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. So this is equals to root of p square plus p square plus 2p square cos 60, that is 1 by 2. So this is equals to root of p square plus p square plus p square. So this is equals to root 3p. Clear? This I will calculate the net electric dipole moment. Done? Okay, another question. Find the ratio of electric field due to dipole along the axis and equator. Consider y equals to z greater than a. This is the condition which has been given. You have been told to calculate the ratio of electric fields due to the dipole lying along the axis and equator, but this is the case where y is equals to z. That means we have been told to calculate the ratio of electric field at two points at equal distance along the axis and along the equator.
but both these distance are quite greater than A. That means we'll use the formula for short dipole.
So along the axis, electric field is 2kp by z cube.
When z is greater than A, electric field along the axis will be 2kp by z cube.
Electric field along the equator will be minus kp by y cube.
These are the formulas to be used when the dipole is short or such kind of conditions are given to you. Now we have been told to find the ratio of electric field, but consider y equals to z.
That means electric field along the axis upon electric field along the equator will be equals to 2kp by z cube into y cube by minus kp. Already y is equals to z, so z cube will get cancelled, so it is minus 2 is to 1. Clear?
In such type of questions, if they are asking the magnitude of electric field, magnitude of ratio of electric field, then it will be 2 is to 1. Done? Clear? See one more question.
Find the similar type question, but it can be asked in a different way. Find the ratio of distance. Find the ratio of distances due to dipole along the axis and equator where electric field due to or electric field along the axis and equator is same. This is your question.
Find the ratio of distances due to a dipole along the axis and equator where electric field along the axis and equator is same. That means in the question now it is given that electric field is same for the axis and equator. You have to find the ratio. You have to find the ratio of distances. That means you have been told to calculate the ratio of z is to y. This ratio should be such that electric field along the axis and along the equator should have the same value, or electric field along the axis and equator should be equal. But consider short dipole. Consider short dipole. Short dipole means A is being neglected. Clear? So, in this question you have been given that electric field along the axis is equals to electric field along the equator. You have been told to calculate the ratio. Find the ratio of distance such that electric field due to dipole along the axis and along the equator comes out to be same. So, electric field along the axis is 2kp by z cube. This is minus kp by y cube. Right? So z cube is to y cube
will be 2 is to 1.
Clear? If I am considering only the value, since we have been told to calculate the ratio of distance,
so z cube by y cube is equals to 2. So z by y is equals to cube root of 2 is to 1. Done?
Clear? Fine. So now in the next lecture, we'll calculate the electric field at a point which is lying neither on the axis nor on the equator. That means if the dipole is placed over here and we'll calculate the electric field at any point P in a plane, the point is neither lying along the axis nor it is lying along the equator. So we'll calculate the formula to find the electric field and then we'll again solve the questions based on electric dipole.